Hello? Is this the mailman? Oh, I do hope my fall catalog has arrived. Oh, Evan, he's such a gentleman. Please, do come inside. Let me unlock the door for you.
What the hell are you doing in here? Get the fuck out. Yeah, right. And the second I drop my guard, you pounce. No thanks. Look, speak your piece, then leave. We're great, just peachy. I love sitting in my house with my thumb up my ass. Tell Mr. King that sitting here all day isn't going to make us any safer. We need to take action. Well, he's town mayor or sheriff or whatever he calls himself. He calls all the shots. When he says to get the heck indoors and stay put, we do that. Everyone is keeping themselves safe from the family. If I was you, I'd do the same. You want to know more? Talk to Evan King. They're low-life scum who decided to use Arafu as their own personal amusement park. Oh, they're a fun bunch. I'd take a shot at them if I could, but judging from what they did to the Brahmin, I wouldn't live long to tell about it. Good.
You must be exhausted from all that walking in this horrible heat. Oh, and hungry too. Sit, please. Brayley Ewers is the name. Don't mind my husband, Kenneth. He woke up on the wrong side of the bed this morning.
Yes. Who is it? Oh, he did? Well, it's about damn time he did something. Come on in. I'll unlock the door.
It's nice to see a friendly new face around here. It's been a long time. The name's Karen Shenzi. Scared out of my mind! I'm glad he's checking on us, but until someone nips the problem in the bud, we may as well stay inside forever. He's a spineless wimp. His best solution to the family is to stay inside our homes and hide. What does that tell them? It tells them that we can be pushed around whenever they want. I'm sick of it, and I'm sick of King. We're scared shitless. Evan King's got everyone so worked up about the family, no one wants to set foot outside. That asshole runs the show. But does he really do anything about our problem? No. All they do is terrorize us. They taunt us to open our doors, throw bottles at our houses, and scream at us. If I knew King had my back, I'd step outside and show them just how I feel about their visits, especially after this last attack. Thank you.
What did they tell you? Everyone okay? The family must have gotten to them in the last attack. Sons of bitches. Damn it! If only we had more men, we could stand up to them. I'm sick of them terrorizing this town. Wait a minute. When you searched the West's place, did you find their son Ian's body? This has to be the work of the family. I've caught that weirdo leader of theirs talking to Ian down by the river. Look, I know I've asked a lot of you already, but you have to find that kid. He deserves better than all this. Thanks, kid. You're all right.
What do you need? Another satisfied customer. Thank you.
gonna tear your fucking throat. You like that? You like that?
Thank you. President Eaton, and I was hoping we could talk. It's time we discuss something rather important. The issue at hand is, well, your presence. The question has been raised, I know, as to just how I came to be elected to this most illustrious office, or whether or not I had been elected at all. That I must answer, of course. Of course I was elected, sweet America. Of course. Isn't the right to vote the very foundation of a democracy? Fortunately, in the interest of national security, I'm not at liberty to discuss the details of the election. You understand? But rest assured, I am your president. Because the appropriate people of this great nation decided. I am your duly elected representative. Of course, when the time comes, when the time is up, America will be free to elect the president. That person will have our full faith and confidence and carry our collective values forward into the future. Democracy, dear America. Democracy now and forever. For now, my America, we must part. Restoring the greatest country in the world to its former glory.
Not here to try and steal my secrets, are you? Good. I was afraid I was going to have to abandon my lab here. That would mean starting all over again. It's not easy trying to make Ultra Jet, you know. I suppose you could say that. Ultra Jet is almost double the potency of Jet. Perfect for ghouls. Jet barely affects us, you see. Only trouble is, it's almost impossible to gather the ingredients together. Say, you might be able to help me with that. It takes three things to make Ultra Jet. Two of the ingredients I got plenty of. The other one is a little harder to find. Sugar bombs. I distill it down to its base contents and add that to the formula, then presto, Ultra Jet. For every box of sugar bombs you bring me, I'll pay you 15 caps. So, you in? Nope. Good.
Whoa, slow down there. This area's off limits to everyone but the family. Where the hell do you think you're going? I don't care. All right. I guess you look harmless enough. If I were you, I'd speak to Vance before you poke around too much. You can usually find him on the mezzanine overlooking the common area. This lovely hole in the ground is Moresti, the headquarters of the family. We are a badass gang, and we don't take shit from nobody. We also don't like nosy assholes who creep around asking too many stupid questions. Why don't you look where you're going?